Well, as much as you might be trying to hide from it, there's no getting around it. Tomorrow, 2 billion pairs of eyes will be fixed on London for what's being hailed as the wedding of the year. Some say the decade. One of those watching very closely is our senior foreign correspondent, Hamish McDonald.
Yeah, thanks very much indeed, George. Welcome back to London. All this week on 6.30, we've been asking the question, is Great Britain still great? We've looked at immigration, race, the economy, class, debt. We've asked some of the big questions about the UK now and into the future. But now we are turning our attentions to the big event at hand. In a sense, this is an opportunity for the UK to prove its critics wrong. There is a last-minute flurry diplomatically about whether the Syrian ambassador should in fact attend the wedding, because obviously his government is involved in a brutal crackdown on its own people. Meanwhile, Tony Blair and Gordon Brown are not invited to the wedding, while former Conservative Prime Ministers John Major and Margaret Thatcher are. Of course, the security operation is now well and truly underway. Concerns about the potential for terrorists to target the big event. Danielle Isdale is here in London with more on the security operation.
Thanks, Hamish. Well, there's not long to go now, and it's not just the bride and groom who are nervous. Spare a thought for the London Metropolitan Police. They've been tasked with securing this enormous world event. It is a logistical nightmare at a time when the terror threat level in Britain is still considerably high. Now, these last 24 hours are the time for final police briefing, the time for the last of these steel barriers to be put into place. To ask how it will all work, we went to Scotland Yard.
We've been planning this for 22 weeks now. We have a highly experienced command team in place, and the Metropolitan Police does carry out over 4,500 different events per year in the centre of London.
I guess the sad fact is you would have to prepare for all sorts of ugly scenarios in a situation like this.
I think with any operation in central London where you're combining protected people and a security operation with a celebration, of course you must plan for all sorts of eventualities, and that's where our experience and our command team come into play.
Is it stalkers you're looking out for? Is it Islamic terror groups? Is it the IRA? I mean, have you identified certain groups of people?
We would monitor a whole range of different potential threats, but as I say, in terms of domestic terrorism, Republican terrorism, and terrorism from Al-Qaeda, there is no change to the threat level in the United Kingdom at this stage.
Is this the wrong time to have an event like this?
The fact is that there is a royal couple who want to get married, and we are going to facilitate that, and we're going to make sure that everybody who attends enjoys their day.
How many officers, and will some be undercover?
There's at least 5,000 officers. Yes, we will have some officers in plain clothes, but not undercover. That's a slightly different type of activity. But we'll have officers in both plain clothes and uniform.
Is 5,000 police officers enough for 500,000 people and 50 heads of state?
It's certainly, as far as we are concerned, assessed to be sufficient to meet the demands of the day.
Now, there have been lots of protests in the capital over the past year now. We've seen rioting and all sorts of issues. Are the Metropolitan Police confident that they can be in control of these sort of situations?
I think it's really important to remember that this is about public ceremony, not public protest. This is a real celebration of our royal family. It's a real celebration for all that is British, and it's a celebration for everybody who wants to come to London to enjoy the spectacle. There is a big difference between that and a pre-organised public protest, and we are policing it as such. But I would reiterate that anybody who intends to come to London and commit criminal acts or disrupt the royal wedding will be dealt with appropriate to the circumstances that surround them at that time.
Danielle Isdale there reporting from Scotland Yard. Well, you will pretty much have to be hiding under a rock tomorrow to avoid the royal wedding celebrations. There's blanket coverage here in the United Kingdom, and there probably will be right around the world. Now, the difference between the last big royal wedding and this one is social media. People will be taking to the blogosphere, the Twittersphere, Facebook and everything else you can imagine to comment on what happens tomorrow.
When it comes to royalty, it has always been a case of us and them. But in a world of social media, that relationship is changing. Suddenly, the House of Windsor is getting tech savvy.
I think they're very keen to show that they're just like us and that they are using the internet.
Friday's wedding is to be streamed live via a dedicated YouTube channel. There's also an online wedding book where anyone can upload a personal message for the bride and groom.
We're going to be hosting a big barbecue for lots of our friends. So we'll be thinking of you on your big day.
We'll be having lots of drinks to celebrate. Hope everything goes well, and I hope the British weather holds out for you.
The numbers are astounding. 9,000 wedding mentions every day online. That's one every 10 seconds. Remarkable, considering just how much else is going on in the world.
I think it's going to be a very big event. I think it will be very big, especially in terms of current affairs, and I expect it to be bigger than other current affairs events like the televised leaders' debates. I'm not sure it's going to be as big as the World Cup final, for example.
There's no doubt this event will be huge online, but the truth is that traditional media still dominates. Take a look at this. It's one of the massive structures built to house the international media. Broadcasters are paying tens of thousands of dollars for one of those tiny little commentary boxes. On the day, there's an expectation that some 2 billion people will be watching the event on television. If you are watching from the couch, you could try this, an iPhone app that provides a 3D tour of Westminster Abbey, just in case the endless live broadcasts aren't quite enough. Of course, social media is inherently uncontrolled, so the royals will also hear exactly what people think.
The fact that William and Kate are actually of the age where everyone else is using Twitter, Facebook and YouTube means that a lot of people, all their peers, are going to be using these avenues to record their well wishes and dissect every single turn of events on the day.
One mobile phone company has already scored a royal hit online. 12 million people have watched this spoof wedding video. I'm sure that one's going to be probably more exciting than the event itself. Well, do join us online if you can for our royal wedding coverage. The address is 10.com.au/royalwedding. You can also join the conversation using Twitter and the hashtag 10royalwedding. Now, I'll be here tomorrow night for a special edition of 6:30 from Westminster Abbey. Abbey will have reporters across the UK in some of the big locations where parties will be taking place. Then that'll be followed by a special edition of the 7pm project. I'll be joining Carrie Bickmore for that, and then we'll roll into the live coverage throughout the night right here on Network 10. So, George, either you'll join us or you'll be hiding under a rock. See you later.
Thanks, Hamish. Happy nuptials.